Chairman, Co-Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Dr. KRIANGSAK, PIYAKUNMALA from Khonkan Hospital, Thailand. Today, I would like to present my research in the title of Effect of Cross-Suction Drainage Tube Length After Total Knee Arthroplasty, a Double-Blind Randomized Control Trial. Disclosure. Introduction, the postoperative period after total knee arthroplasty surgery is associated with significant blood loss requiring blood transfusion. The greatest blood loss occurs with 55% of total blood loss in first 4 hours. Several methods have been shown to be effective in reduced blood loss, but limited in some patients, such as tranexamic acid, temporary drain, cramp, and no drain. A cross-suction drainage system is routinely used for removing collect blood, which can be a cause of infection and wound complication. However, those methods frequently increase blood loss because they reduce the entire capsular tamponade effect. The purpose. At present, there have been no clinical study of the correlation between the length of suction drainage and amount of postoperative blood loss. The number of side holes in drainage catheter is directly proportional to the length of suction drainage tube. We hypothesize a shorter drain length, fewer side holes, would result in reduced postoperative blood loss after TKA. The purpose of this study was to compare the quantity of blood loss in 3 cm, 14 side holes, and 7 cm, 32 side holes suction drainage catheter as a control group. Material method. 140 patients with osteoarthritis who underwent unilateral TKA at Department of Orthopedic Khonkan Hospital, study from August 2012 to January 2015. Patients were randomized assigned by computer generated number and sealed in an opaque envelope. Exclusion criteria were simultaneous bilateral TKA, bleeding disorder, previous knee surgery, and anticoagulant use. Our TKA were performed by same surgeon, same technique, and used identical type of prosthesis. During wound closure, the landmine number envelope was opened and the assisting surgeon inserted the suction drainage catheter in the lateral cutter of the knee. The cross-suction drain was pre-evacuated to 980 millibar pressure and came for the first 4 postoperative hours. The amount of drainage in the cross-suction bottom and hematocrit level were recorded until 72 hours. Red blood cells were transfused if the hematocrit level was below than 30%. Wound complication such as wound infection, abnormal wound discharge, fever, monitor until discharge from the hospital. The assessor did not know the group of patients. Our patient had the same postoperative physical therapy protocol and non-lesive deep vein thrombosis prophylaxis. For the results, at the demographic data is no difference between group. For the result in comparison to the operative time, blood loss, hematocrit, blood transfusion, wound condition, we found in the postoperative blood loss at the 8-hour and 16-hour is a significant difference. It's less in the 3 cm drain length. And we found for the red blood cell transfusion at the 48-hour is less than the shorter length than less than the longer length. And wound complication is the same. Limitation for this study. First, the amount of blood in the suction drainage bottom was not the exact amount of postoperative blood loss because some blood loss remained in the knee joint. However, the amount of blood in the suction bottom was the most practical method. Second, Suction drain function can be disturbed by kink or pinch catheter during the postoperative rehabilitation program. Conclusion, the length of suction drain tube was associated with the amount of postoperative blood loss after TKA surgery. A 3 cm drain significantly reduced blood loss in first 16 hours and reduced red blood cell transfusion at 48 hours postoperatively compared to the 7 cm drain. A shorter drain length method was shown to be both easy and safe. Thank you for attention.
Thank you. So any questions from the audience? Barak, please.
I think that's a very nice study you did. First time I'm seeing something like this to reduce the length and the number of holes. But did you compare this with using no drain at all?
No, I did not include.
Did not include that. But yes. Maybe for the future, it might be a good study to see because more surgeons are now moving to not using drain at all. And then that reduces significantly the blood loss. But a good paper. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.